The Plasmatics were like no other band. It was just an outrageous, crazy, fantastic band from the 80s.
In your monkey suit, you just look like a monkey.
It was like the Rocky Horror Show, a collision of theater and madness.
The band just took things to a complete different level. We used to blow up Cadillacs on stage. We've done everything.
So there's Wendy with gaffer tape on the ends of her breasts, chainsawing a guitar.
We had such opposites. Like I said, you had Richie, a 6'4", 6'5" guy with a blue mohawk. You had a black guy with a blonde mohawk.
A rhythm guitar player is hanging himself at the end of the gig. Speakers are exploding. The guitar player's in a tutu, banging his head and his blood up.
People came to the show because they were wondering what might happen.
I swear, a bolt or something came off the car and shot past my head.
Being in the Plasmatics as a rule was a danger and something we all took on. Wendy O Williams, our lead singer from Plasmatics, was a flamboyant, quite extravagant woman. Foam on her breasts and, you know, sledgehammer, black tights. I mean, just outrageous. She'd do whatever she felt like doing. She helped really bring the band to a different level and to propel it just by just being totally outrageous. In a monkey suit, you just look like a monkey. It was basically about people in suit and ties, just the people who conform. Because the Plasmatics were about non-conforming. We could dress how we want, we could do what we want. And that was the statement, that you don't have to dress up in a suit and follow the man. You know, you just do what you want. Because in a monkey suit, you just look like a monkey.
In the summer of 1980, the Plasmatics had a really important show at the Hammersmith Odeon. It was a headlining gig, the release of their first album, a big press push, and everything that goes with that. But before the show could take place, because of all the pyrotechnics the band used, the Greater London Council safety people wanted to come down and check out what was going on. And what really interested them was the exploding car sequence.
Pyro guy obviously thought, well, I'm going to really downplay this thing.
So a tiny explosion takes place, a door creaks and falls about 6 inches from the car.
Because that was enough. They said, oh, there's been movement there. I could just see that thing moved. Well, yeah, but it's only, you know, just, it hardly, no, I'm sorry, you can't, we won't allow any movement.
And now Rod Swenson, the band's manager, is told the only way the gig can take place is if the exploding car sequence is removed from the band's show.
Rod refused to make any changes to the show as it was.
So the gig was cancelled. The next day I put together a press conference and writers from every single major UK paper showed up with photographers. Huge coverage. The band climbs on the plane, flies back to New York without playing a single note in the UK, and that was the release of New Hope for the Wretched.
I think what the band left in the music industry was very important in terms of theatrics and making artists feel that they could go the extra mile. And I kind of wish there was more of that these days. I think it was one of the best moments in my life. It played a big part in me being who I am, because that lesson I learned from the Plasmatics.
Monkey Suit is released on the new Stiff box set, 10 Big Stiffs, and distributed by Razor and Tie. Stiff Records, where the fun never sets.